Hello, everybody. We are on day 9 of our 12 days of Christmas giveaway. So I would love to hear what you guys think about this, if you're finding it beneficial, if you like it. I know that you guys are looking for the measurements for everything, and I will absolutely post them. I was just wanting to get the videos done and posted and that kind of thing. So I will go and I will post all the measurements for all the projects. But if there's something specific that you're looking for before I get a chance to do that, can you please message me and let me know? And I would absolutely love to provide you with those. Okay. So today's project, actually, we're going to do two little quick projects. And this is more of a fun giving type thing. It's more as something you could probably put on instead of a bow, maybe. They're two little boxes. No, not boxes. Well, I guess one's a box. Here, let me show you. Oh, I got things flying around here. Okay, so the first one is this, and it's called a sour cream container, because apparently, way before my time, when you're in restaurants, you used to get sour cream for your potatoes in something that looked very similar to this. So you would, you could put something in here, like candies or a ring or a bracelet or earrings or whatever. And I just think that's super cute. So we could actually put some holes in here, put some ribbon around it, that kind of thing. So that's the one item that we're going to make today. So I didn't actually decorate this one. And the other one is what we call a 2, 4, 6, 8 box. And it's exactly that. You're scoring at 2, 4, 6, and 8. And then it's actually kind of referred to as a milk carton box as well. So this is another really fun box. And then again, you could just poke some holes there, run some ribbon through it, and away we go. Now my glue's all falling apart in here because the humidity here at the studio is crazy. But let's go ahead and make those together, okay? So the first one we're gonna do is our sour cream container. So what you need is actually just a piece of paper, designer series paper. You can use regular cardstock too if you'd like, but designer series paper at 4 by 6. I'm just trying to get some of the glue off my desk here because it's kind of crazy. So this paper is actually from the Curvy Celebrations bundle that was out for a limited time. And I have lots of it, so I thought it would be a great paper to use. So it's already 6 by 6. So I'm just gonna cut this down to 4. You're gonna love how simple this is actually. So I'm gonna put my paper cutter over here. So now what I'm gonna do is I need to decide which pattern I want on the outside. And I think I'm gonna use the stripes on the outside again. So what I'm actually gonna do is I'm gonna run some adhesive just down the side here. Again, I'm getting adhesive all over my desk, and I'm going to run some along the bottom. Now, years ago, we had what we would call a crimper, and this worked really awesome for this project. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually adhere these two together. So I'm kind of making like a tube is basically what I'm making here. It looks like a toilet paper roll, really, okay? So I'm just adhering that. So now the part where I put the adhesive on the bottom, I'm actually going to squeeze that. This is, you want it strong adhesive for this, okay? So that's making the flat part of our box, right? So again, years ago we had a crimper, so we would just crimp that so that it would look like it was exactly like a sour cream container. Now, I could take a piece of designer series paper and cover this up, right? Well, obviously not this pattern, but and cover that up and dress it up. For sure, I could, okay? So then what I would do is I would fill my contents, right? I'm just gonna get this off my screen. Fill my box with whatever it is I'm gonna put in it. So whether it's chocolates or mints, here I have some mints back here. Mints in here. I got a bag of goodies here. Let's see what I can find in here. Okay, so then I don't want to glue this like this because then I'm just ending up with a pouch. What I want to do is I want to go the opposite direction. So I'm folding the top the opposite way. So this one is going this way. this one, I'm squeezing the opposite direction. So I'm kind of making it a T. So what I'm going to actually do is I'm going to go ahead and put some adhesive in here. If I can get my glue to work, that is. Okay. And I'm going to put this in here like this. Now what I'm going to do though, let's see how cute is that? So I'm actually going to take my crop-a-dial or my hole punch. If you don't have a crop-a-dial, you can use a hole punch. And I'm actually just going to punch a couple holes in here so that I can make sure that stays sealed. And I'm going to just use my red, what are we calling this? This is, let's look at this. Braided linen trim is what it's called. I'm just going to run it through here. So this would be a really, really super cute gift for like the newspaper person or, you know, somebody just need a little something for it, or to replace as a bow on a gift. It's just all in the presentation, right? Oops, and this is a little bit harder to do on this box when it's on a different angle. Okay, so this is not a very pretty bow, so no judgment. Okay, I'll have to make it more pretty. Okay, but you get the idea. Okay, don't look at how ugly that bow is, but how cute is that, right? So this would be like really even as a countdown calendar, like an advent calendar or something would have been super cute too. Or just even a hang from your tree, right? And every day you have a different gift in it. Would have been really cute too. Okay, so that is the first one that we're doing. So that's called your sour cream container. The other project I want to share with you today is what we call a 2, 4, 6, 8 box. So it's exactly that. It's a 2, 4, 6, and 8 box. So this, what I'm using here is I'm going to use the Heartwarming Hugs paper. And my paper is, oh, I think this is actually supposed to be 8.5, actually. Let me grab another piece of paper. Maybe I won't use Heartwarming Hugs, because I'm pretty sure this has to be 8.5, not 8, because it won't work otherwise. So let me do this again. 8.5. There we go. By... Okay, so I lied. I'm using the poinsettia paper on this one. Let's put this to the side for a second. Okay, so I'm going to use the poinsettia part out. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come in and I'm going to score at 2, 4, 6, and 8. So do you see why I said 8 wouldn't work? Because I need this piece here, this half inch. Okay, so 2, 4, 6, and 8. So my paper is 8.5. So I'm going to rotate this and I'm going to score at 2. Just once. Okay, that's it. That's all we have to do as far as scoring, not as far as the box, but okay. So it's probably hard to see, my guess. Is okay, so you can't see it any better here, so you're gonna have to take my word for it. So I have a score line here, which is my half inch score line, score line, score line, and a score line. Okay, so what I need to do is I need to remove this little tab here. So I'm going to come in with my scissors and I only want to go up to the first score line because that's an extra piece that we do not need. Okay. Okay, now I need to cut up on each of these score lines here. And here. And one more. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I am going to fold on all my score lines. And if I was smart, I would grab my bone folder, which is right here. So I really like this part of the pattern too, but I want to use that red thread ribbon again. So Now, what I should have told you actually is when you were cutting those, is just kind of mitering in those flaps. And what that does, you've seen me do this on the other videos. What this does is actually when you're going to lay your, put your flaps in, it just helps everything sit a little bit better. And you don't want to take a lot out because you don't want gaps, but you just want enough that will help your flaps just sit flat. Because sometimes they bunch up because there's just too much. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to run my glue along this half inch flap here, like that. And that is actually going to seal my box. So what I did was I folded at the first crease and I'm just going to lay my box down flat. Okay, so that just ensures that everything matches nicely. Okay, and then what I need to do is just put my flaps in as such. So I'm going to put some glue here. Do that. And I'll put some glue here. That. So this is a really awesome box for so many things. So then, got my box done. So then I'm just going to kind of squeeze in the sides, and this is what's making it my milk carton. I'm just squeezing it there like that. Okay, so now I can punch my holes here and here. And then what that's going to do is close my box. And then I'm going to use my braided thread. I'm going to maybe use the big holes. It's going to make my braided thread go through nicely and tie. So you want to try to make your holes somewhat even. So now if I don't use my braided thread, I could use a thicker ribbon actually on this one, which might work out nicely as well. Should put this one through here. And so this is, I've used this box, oh my gosh, so many times. It's an oldie, but it's definitely a fave. Okay, so then I'm just gonna tie this and then hopefully tie a bow. So this is probably the worst part, is trying to get this all tucked away so sweet. And of course, making my bow look pretty, because on camera, it never looks pretty when I need to look pretty. Way actually, because I want to go. I might change the ribbon on this one anyway, but you guys get the feel for that. That's not a very pretty ribbon, but you see how cute that box is. So we have our sour cream container, and then we have our 2, 4, 6, 8 box. Okay, so super cute box. Just if you want to add a little extra something on your gift, this is always a nice option. And then even if it just has a little bit of Lindor candies in it or something like that, it's always a great add-on. Okay, so hopefully you enjoyed that. If you have any questions or concerns, let me know. And like I said, I will be posting all the measurements for all the projects. But don't forget about the last chance sale for those items that are retiring. There's some really, really good items that I'm sad to see go. But you know what? What goes out, if there's stuff leaving, that means there's lots of great stuff coming in. So I hope you guys are enjoying this. Thanks for joining me. If you have any questions or concerns, please let me know. Okay. Thanks, guys. Have a great night. Bye.